Hi, today I've launched on Facebook Virtual Remembrance. I've ever since 2003, when my partner's plaque was stolen off a remembrance wall in Pariwa Cemetery, Auckland, I thought I don't want to pay half the price, which was then $1,500, for another plaque just to be stolen again. There was a whole load of plaques stolen, melted down. Basically sold for money, and ever since that moment, I've wanted to put something back so people can see it. Those that are related to me and my other half. I had visited the cemetery. I took some videos. I also took a photograph of the remembrance wall, so I had a photograph of that plaque. Ever since then, I have visited cemeteries. And sometimes you can't read the headstone. Recently, just last month, June 2020, I went to Frankston Cemetery, which is just outside of Melbourne, and well, Melbourne suburb. I visited the cemetery and came across plaques that appear to have been removed, one that was prized up, so I'm guessing someone has tried to nick it. I don't know whether there is a business over here where you can sell stolen plaques and, as metal, so you get the value of whatever the steel is worth. I wrote a Google review about the cemetery, and I mentioned about the visibility of theft, and they said it was sad. I thought, yeah, it is sad. I've been thinking about the way I'd like to end this life, and I think I'd probably like to be put in a cardboard box, cheap one, cremated, ashes scattered. Do you know the ashes actually come in a bag and they put them in a container? Now, if you want to spend hundreds of dollars on a container, fine, but mine was actually in a plastic box, and I took the ashes to Pariwa Cemetery and scattered them. I also took some ashes down to Queenstown, South Auckland, sorry, South Island, New Zealand. And yeah, so for me, cardboard box, cremation, and a plaque online, because how many people go to cemeteries these days? I know if someone has recently died and you're still connected, you'll go. But I kid you not, I've taken over 3,000 photographs in the last couple of months, and the damage I'm seeing to stones, plaques, whether the, I could talk for hours on what I've seen, but the way out of it is you go with the virtual world, because that's where everyone is today. People want to know about the, when people visit cemeteries, for me, for instance, I'm looking at the stones, the designs. There are some beautiful stones out there, and the architecture is magnificent. But it's the same information: where you were born, date of birth, date of death, where you resided. Sometimes, not always. Sometimes it's the simplest of plaques, sometimes it's more elaborate. And talk about cost. I thought the Italians, spent a lot of money on their stones, but I came across some Greek headstones, and goodness, it's unreal the amount of money that must be spent. And do you know the remembrance memorials that stand the test of time, the longest, I believe, are the thick wooden blocks that have been sculpted. So I've actually got a couple that I've photographed. So I'm going to put those on the remembrance site. I might have to ask for permission. I've touched them up in Photoshop. I've got Photoshop running behind me. So that's another project. My friend Brendan and I are going to produce a book, hopefully later this year. That's about it for now. I'll post a link to the Facebook page.